Whilst we see mammalian tissue culture being used ubiquitously throughout our industry these days, from anything from drug discovery right through to developing new materials or foods, we still see most of these operations being carried out enormously manually. So one of the biggest challenges is that simple process of keeping our cell cultures alive, and that involves the process of feeding them on a daily basis. Now, the implication that has from a scientist's perspective, that means long sessions locked in front of tissue culture hoods doing media exchanges or passaging experiments, or worst case scenario, having to come in late at night or at weekends in order to take care of their living cells. This is enormously onerous and leads to an enormous amount of frustration. Like, why do I need to come in at the weekend to take care of my experiments? Is there not a better way of doing this? And can I not focus more on the outcomes of these experiments and analyze the data that I want to generate by producing these cell lines in the first place? I think classically today, we have started seeing automation being applied, and it's typically being used just to increase that numbers game. So we start, for example, in cell line development activities, putting more into that top end of the funnel, so we have a higher chance of getting some kind of characterized lead out of the other end. But what if we could go a little bit further than that? What happens if we start extending out the capabilities of these automation platforms? We believe that labs haven't tapped into the full potential of automation, and our approach to this is called open integrated automation. When we say integrated, we mean physically and digitally connecting individual devices that deliver the right capabilities so the workflow itself becomes one seamless automated process. It increases efficiencies across processes by being completely hands-off, freeing up your most valuable asset, your scientists, to get on with the actual science. When we say open, our platform is open in two ways. First, it's vendor agnostic, enabling labs to work with the instruments they already have and find the best fit for the gaps. Second, it's collaborative. We build human-centric platforms, so people in the lab can still interact with their workflow. We understand that science is about iteration and improvement. We've developed a modular approach, so labs can modify and scale their workflows as their needs grow. And all of this is unified in one software platform, saving you and your scientists valuable time. With this concept of open integrated automation, people in the lab can do more with less, minimize error and contamination risk, reduce manual interactions, avoid antisocial working hours, and improve repeatability, all while improving the quality and quantity of data collected from their workflows. Quite simply put, the approach that we take at Automata is going to enable greater adoption of automation in these kinds of laboratories. We can see that if you start utilizing small units of operation to do simple things like keeping those cells fed and carrying out things like passaging out of hours, then all of a sudden all of those burden of manual operations go away. And then we can start thinking about how we scale upon that. And that leads us on to then think about what kind of experimentation we can do tomorrow that we can't really do today.